Folks, we have about 20 minutes of uncut fairy tale gameplay. We finally have an idea of what this game will be. We got some free roaming, combat, progression. We got a lot. So I'm gonna quickly take you through these 20 minutes of gameplay, let you know what's happening and what my opinion on it is. But if you wanna watch the full 20 minutes uncut, the link for that video is in the description down below. First of all, the setting. I didn't make it this far in fairy tale, but if you're a fan, if you've watched the anime, you probably know where this takes place. A lot of fairy tale mages have been frozen in a stasis for about 7 years and they've been presumed dead. So the fairy tale guild just kinda doesn't exist anymore, and now every mage comes back and you're building it back up from scratch. Means you gotta do some easy missions to start, and as you go, you increase your guild rank back up to what it was, and maybe even go beyond that and become the number one guild. If you didn't watch Fairy Tail, it seems the game will tell you the story up to this point, which is really good if you just want to learn more about Fairy Tail by just getting the game. All these cutscenes are voice acted, though this mission is part of the main story. It's unclear whether side missions will also be voice acted, but it's good to see that at least the main missions are voiced. All the voice work is in Japanese for now, no confirmation on English dub. I know a lot of you guys really care about an English dub version of your anime games, but so far, Japanese only, nothing else has been confirmed. So you arrive at your guild hall, and it's very empty, but you do have a D rank mission on the board, and that's the focus of this demo. You're gonna accept this mission, which basically says that some thugs have robbed the post office and you gotta get that mail back, because mail is what keeps people connected or something, so that's why it's important, even though it's a low rank mission. Now at this point, you haven't unlocked Erza as a team member, but she joins your party as a guest. Specific quests will have specific characters attached to them for different reasons, and Erza is especially linked to this quest for a reason that we'll find out at the end of the demo. So you'll leave the guild hall, and as you explore, you have some items to pick up off the ground. These will be used for crafting, but crafting isn't ready to be shown, so we'll ignore that for now. From the guild hall, you enter the city of Magnolia, rendered in 3D for the very first time, and it looks really good. Pretty much as I remember it from the anime, so overall a very nice recreation. It looks like a nice place to explore, and hopefully there's a lot to do here. But in this demo, we're gonna exit Magnolia, and as you do, you'll see a world map. From here, you can select different regions to go to, and this demo takes you to a rocky mountain sort of region, but they've mentioned lava and ice regions will be there as well. The typical JRPG tropes all seem to be there. And this is where we get a first look at combat. So, just like in other JRPGs like Dragon Quest, Ni No Kuni, or Persona, you see the enemies before you fight them, and you can try to hit them in this overworld to get an advantage once you actually enter the turn-based battle. Here, the person giving the demo actually missed the attack, so combat just starts as normal. If you had successfully landed that attack, you would be the first ones attacking the enemy. Now, combat still looks a bit rough in my opinion. You can see the birds attacking two different characters, and the game just kind of replaces the model of who's attacking and who's getting attacked. Not a big fan of this transition visually, but it is an early build. And a lot of the animations still have problems that will hopefully get fixed in the future. That will become very, very obvious later in this demo. When it's your turn to attack, you can see you have different commands: using an item, attacking, defending, or using magic, which in this game, magic was probably the option you'll be choosing the most. In battle, enemies are positioned in a 3x3 grid, and your attacks affect different spaces, which is a nice strategic layer. Sometimes you might have an attack that is strong against a certain type of enemy, but if it only hits one of the enemies, it might not be worth doing it. So you constantly have to make that choice of focusing down a single guy or going for multiple enemies at once. When enemies are killed, they give your whole party some MP back, which, since this is a game about mages and you'll be using your magic a lot, it's really cool to be able to get some of that magic power back through combat, so you don't constantly have to buy and use replenishing items all the time. It's a really nice quality of life feature. As you finish a battle, all of your characters level up individually. Their stats go up automatically. You don't put points into stats or anything like that, and they automatically get new spells as well. These spells can have new effects, new areas of effect on that 3x3 grid, and they just sort of become equipped automatically. So there are no menus for increasing stats or talent trees to unlock spells. It's all very automatic, which can be a good or a bad thing depending on what type of game you're looking for. There will be some customization shown off in the future, but it wasn't ready to be shown in this demo. There are different types of damage. In this demo, we've seen fire damage, wind damage, physical, and ice. Different enemies will have different elemental weaknesses, and that's something you have to play around with as well. Though I will say that wind damage shows up as green numbers, and in my head it just looks like I'm healing the enemies, but then healing is also green, so I don't know, maybe just change the wind damage color. It's confusing. As you fight, you'll fill up a gauge that you can see on the lower right corner. It's kind of covered by their camera, but that's the fairy gauge. You can kind of see it in the corner there. Once that's full, you can unleash an ultimate attack, with your entire party, and it covers the whole grid. You can keep calling the next character or choosing who finishes the chain. Not sure why you would finish the chain early, but maybe you can retain some of that gauge if you do so. But either way, the animation at the end is really bad, and they did mention that it would look different in a final game. So this is one of those points where I'm like, yeah, animation needs work. Let's not be too harsh on it, because they are clearly aware of it and they're working on it. So hopefully a future demo will show off what this will potentially look like. And that's kind of it for the combat system. At the end of this mission, we do learn why Erza wanted to join us for this quest, and basically these guys stole a package that Erza had ordered, which was some underwear. Yay, fan service. After that, you return to your guild, complete the quest, get some money, an item, and Erza officially joins your crew. So now you can have her be a part of your party or not. It's up to you who you want to take on each mission. Overall, I think this is a very solid first look at Fairy Tail. I think the game looks very good visually, and it's the type of JRPG that I like. I'm not really a fan of random encounters, so I love it when it's done like this. I like the layers of potential strategy. Obviously, this is an early mission, and you don't really need to strategize anything at this point, because every enemy just dies pretty easily. But looking at the systems that are in place, having the elemental weaknesses, the grid system, and being able to swap out your party characters has the potential to add enough depth to the combat, and I'm a big fan of what I saw so far. The biggest downside so far is animations. They need a lot of work, and hopefully that work gets done until the game's release. That ultimate attack was obviously very bad, but in addition to that, when enemies attack different characters and it just cuts to a different party member getting attacked, I think that looks really, really bad. So hopefully they change that as well. But yeah, solid first look. I really want to know what else you can do in this game. Leveling up seems largely automatic, so I'd love to see a bit more of how you can customize your characters. What can you equip on each character? How do you tweak their stats? That sort of stuff. And what can you do in this city? This seems like a place that I'd really want to explore, to visit different locations, to talk to different people. But I wonder if the game actually gives you a reason to do all that stuff. Are there events to find? Do you get rewarded in any way for exploration? There's still a lot left to show, but so far, very solid showing of the basics. This looks pretty much how a mission will play out from start to finish, which could very well account for 90% of how this game will be played. So I'm glad they showed that, and I can't wait to see more. But what about you guys? What do you think of Fairy Tail so far? Let me know your opinions in the comments down below. I know sometimes it just sounds like I'm asking for comments, but it really helps me get an idea of how this game is being received and how much of this game I should cover. But as always, thank you very much for watching. My name is Globku, and I'll see you guys next time. Boy.